The Catholic Church does permit us to marry Christian non-Catholics, but we cannot marry non-Christian people. So if they're Protestant and they're understanding of the faith, they support you a lot in the faith and things of that nature. I don't want to be like an ultimatum and be like, you can't date any non-Catholics ever. But at the same time, do you really want to have those differences on faith when you have kids? Do you really want to be not eating meat on Fridays and then the kids see dad eating meat on Fridays and they get confused? Why do we go to two different churches? Why doesn't dad say grace with us or pray the rosary? You know, these things play a role in cultivating your child's relationship with God. And so it's very difficult to talk about this topic because I know Catholic women who have dated Protestant men who have either converted to Catholicism or are very supportive of the faith and they haven't had really any issues. But I also know a lot of women who have married Protestant men who the men now want annulments or things of that nature. And it's just a really tricky situation. I always say date within the faith first. You know, we should always be trying to marry and date Catholics because it just makes everything easier when you're on the same page. And from my own personal experience, I can say that dating someone of your own faith eliminates so many issues.
There are two competing systems. There's the sexual revolutionary sexual system, and then there's the traditional Christian, Judeo-Christian sexual system.
Yeah.
Sex and reproduction are absolutely central to a society's life. It colors everything. It affects everything, okay? So one system will drive out the other. They cannot coexist. I think this is now becoming obvious to people, right? That you really can't coexist with one systemic, something that's driving the whole system, you can't do it piecemeal. You know, you're going to end up, one way or the other, you're going to end up driving out. One will drive out the other.
With the left, there's, from what I would say, the simplest answer is that the leftism is the worship of the self. It's the elevation of the self. That's the only coherent kind of thread that I think connects all of what we call leftism and wokeism and everything. And there are a lot of other people talk about whether they're socialist or this and that. And I think those labels play into it sometimes, but at bottom, at the root of all of this, it is a worship of the self. And it is like a religious worship because they believe that the self, sort of the ego, transcends all boundaries and should submit to no control at all, including their own biological identity. They should be able to rewrite by force of their own will, right? And now you might point out that, well, the worship of the self, that's also the definition of Satanism. And to which I would respond, I mean, yes, exactly. So maybe that's just an easier way of putting it.